you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good morning. Welcome all of you, my dear brothers and sisters, especially those of you who are home watching this Mass from your houses. We are coming to listen to the Word of God and to celebrate the Holy Eucharist, this holy sacrifice I offer for all our mothers as the Mother's Day Novena. Now at the beginning, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that we may experience at all times the fruit produced by the Paschal observances. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. We set sail from Troas, making a straight run for Samothrace, and on the next day to Neapolis, and from there to Philippi, a leading city in that district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. We spent some time in that city. On the Sabbath, we went outside the city gate along the river where we thought there would be a place to pray. We sat and spoke with the woman who had gathered there. One of them, a woman named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth, from the city of Thyatira, a worshiper of God, listened, and the Lord opened her heart to pay attention to what Paul was saying. After she and her household had been baptized, she offered us an invitation. if you consider me a believer in the Lord, come and stay at my home. She prevailed on us. The word of the Lord. A responsorial psalm. The Lord takes delight in his people. The Lord takes delight in his people. Sing to the Lord a new song, a praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their king. The Lord takes delight in his people. Let them praise his name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to him with timbre and harp. For the Lord loves his people, and he adorns the lowly with victory. In his people. Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be their throats. This is the glory of all his faithful. Alleluia. The Lord takes delight in his people. Alleluia. 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 The spirit of truth will testify to me, says the Lord, and you also will testify. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from my Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. And you also testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have told you this so that you may not fall away. They will expel you from the synagogues. In fact, the hour is coming when everyone who kills you will think he is offering worship to God. They will do this because they do not know either the Father or me. I have told you this so that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to God. When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. As you noticed, for a couple days or even weeks, we are reading from St. John, and all these biblical readings, the scripture prepares us for that two very important moments that we are going to celebrate now. The Ascension and then the Feast of Pentecost. Jesus prepares his disciples and us for his absence. I have to go, but the Advocate, the Spirit of Truth, comes from my Father. The Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. They remember that moment of Jesus' absence. We know very well, and it was after what happened on Good Friday. Not only that Jesus is not here, he's in his grave, but even he died with such a shameful death. Now, Jesus is preparing them and all of us for another, we cannot even say absence. It is just looking that it is his absence, but it is not. It is the Ascension. And we really believe that he is going to be even more present among us. But as we read in today's first reading, they had such a great experience, his disciples, with the proclaiming of the gospel, and it was like blend of good experience and bad experience. Good, when people were turning their hearts to the Lord, they accepted Jesus, they received the baptism. Even in today's first reading, there is a woman by the name Lydia. She became first believer, and her household, they received the baptism. But there are also these difficulties when they struggle for faith. Jesus tells us, "The hour is coming when everyone who kills you will think he is offering worship to God. They will do this because they have not known either the Father or me." When I read this today in the morning, I just recalled that last month we celebrated. We remarked 1 year from this bombing in Sri Lanka. It happened in April last year on Easter. And the question is it good excuse for them? They will do this because they have not known either the Father or me. But this is what John is telling us, that Jesus said in his farewell speech. Do you remember what he said? "Father, do not count this sin against them, because they do not know what they are doing." We know that it is not an excuse. But we know that this is the part of Christianity and our discipleship as well. Again, I would like to encourage myself and all of you, even in this time of another enemy, when we cannot get together to worship because of the fear from completely different kind of enemy, to develop such a trust in the Lord and to understand that He will use everything for our good. Everything. If you receive the good from God's hands, why not to accept what is bad? Can we say that God is not in control? He was not in control a year ago in Sri Lanka, or He's not in control today? Of course He is. He was in control even when Jesus was about to go and to accomplish His sacrifice on the Good Friday. He was. And we know that. We are invited to develop this incredible, great trust, like the child has this trust to his father or mother in time of difficulties, believing that they are the only ones who can protect me. In this month of May, when we pay special attention and devotion to our Blessed Mother, and every single day when God gives us new opportunity to do something beautiful for the greater glory of God, to develop this, how I wish, and I believe that all of us, to develop this trust, because this is the only virtue that can bring peace to our souls. Amen. My beloved brothers and sisters, let us turn to our Heavenly Father and, consoled and strengthened by the Advocate, let us present our prayers. For those who speak boldly in the spirit of truth, we pray. For those who mislead others and do violence in God's name, we pray. For those who testify on behalf of justice and fairness for anyone oppressed, we pray. for those shunned and shamed by family members or faith communities, we pray. For those abandoned to depression, addiction, illness, or grief, we pray. And now let us pray for our own personal intentions that we brought to this holy sacrifice. We pray to the Lord. And in this month of May, let us turn to our Blessed Mother, and we ask her for her protection for all of us, but especially all our mothers for whom this holy sacrifice is being offered. We pray to the Lord. And let's conclude these prayers with Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Come to share in the divinity of Christ who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Accepted by the Lord, our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing. And cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you and more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of all to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Timothy our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. And now let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. This mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
joy and in my tears. Oh God, your presence is real. Fly like a bird to the Lord, my soul. I want to soar like a extend a gentle hand, and I know you'll understand. Oh God, your presence is real. Fly like a bird to the Lord, my soul. I want to soar.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let's go in peace.